they can expect to see some of the best racing in the country, and that's exciting for everyone.
14 News got a sneak peek of what you can expect this racing season at Ellis Park, a day after we learned there's a new owner. We'll take you live to Ellis Park coming up, but first, more storms are moving into the tri-state. Chief Meteorologist Jeff Lyons is tracking the latest for us in the Weather Center.
And Kate, here's a look at a live picture now from Madisonville. That shelf cloud moving right over downtown right now, and that is delivering some very gusty winds and heavy rainfall. Again, this is the live view of Madisonville. We don't have a warning there at this time, but some strong thunderstorms rolling in. The severe thunderstorm watch actually trimmed out now, does not include the Evansville metro area. Earlier storms have stabilized the atmosphere, so we're a little less volatile out there for storms. To our radar now in the middle here, we have rain, of course, moving across for the commute, as we figured we would. And then Madisonville, you were just looking at that shelf cloud coming in. There's the heavy rain behind it. There are some warnings a little farther down there, closer to the lakes, but for now anyway, we have no warning for Madisonville at this time, although you may get some 30 to 40 mile an hour wind gusts and even higher. There's another line of storms developing behind this line. This will affect primarily western Kentucky, and so the watch will continue until 9 p.m. for those areas. Today we dropped to 70 and we hit 84 for the high. That's what's fueling some of these storms. We'll look ahead to our next round for thunderstorms in just a few minutes.
And we'll keep you updated throughout the night on these storms on air on 14news.com and on our First Alert app. You can also send us any pictures of damage to upload at 14news.com. Now, all of this rain is impacting Angel Mounts. Their first ever Great American Campout has been canceled because of flooding. Aria Janelle went out there to take a look at the park conditions.
It's spots just like this one that are causing Angel Mounds to have to cancel their first ever Great American Campout.
With all the rain coming through the tri-state, many spots on the ground are filled with water and mud. There's been so much rain that they haven't even been able to mow the grass. This weekend is National Campout Day, a day to encourage the community to get outside, an event that would be the first of its kind for Angel Mounds.
We have camping spaces usually allowed for Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts and organizations like that. But we were going to try it with the general public, and we're going to do some nighttime programs on the site and talk about the Native American components that make Angel Mounds what Angel Mounds is.
The site manager tells me they were really excited about this event, so much so that they're going to keep trying to have it. They said probably in July and August will be their best bets when that rain really settles down. In Evansville, Aria Janelle, 14 News.
Today, Ellis Park officials hosted Media Day ahead of their upcoming race season. We reported to you yesterday that Kentucky Horse Racing Commissioners approved the sale of Ellis Park to Ellis Entertainment LLC. Joseph Payton continues our coverage live at Ellis Park. And Joseph, it sounds like they have a lot to be excited about.
They certainly do, Kate. And I know there's been a lot of conversation, a lot of talk about the sale surrounding Ellis Park here this summer, and especially this week, considering yesterday we were just in Florence, Kentucky, where we had that approval from the Kentucky Horse Racing Commissioners. But today at Media Day, Racing Secretary Dan Bork made sure to remind everybody that there will be horse racing here on this track this summer. And he says it has the potential to be possibly the best year of racing that they have ever had here at Ellis Park. Ellis Entertainment LLC has committed lots of upgrades to the facility that include a hotel and track lighting, but upgrades have already been in the works here. Dangerous parts of the grandstand here where I'm standing have been replaced. The clubhouse and dining area will have new carpet and ceiling tiles. They even dumped 300 tractor loads of sand on the track, and this year the purses have increased to $330,000 per day. Bork says the fans should expect a huge year of racing.
Ellis Park is now such a huge part of the Kentucky racing circuit, and it's great to see it. It needs to be. I mean, it's embraced always here by the fans, but now when they come out, they're going to expect to see. They can expect to see some of the best racing in the country, and that's exciting for everyone.
Now, I also spoke with Ellis Park General Manager Jeff Hall earlier today. He said that this transformation is going to be like going from a Volkswagen to a Mercedes. Pretty good analogy from him there. You'll hear more from him coming up later at 6 o'clock. Live in Henderson, Joseph Payton, 14 News.
Thanks, Joseph. Good news for McLean County. Kentucky transportation officials were there today to announce more than $500,000 worth of road improvements. Tanner Holbrook is just back from Calhoun, where they made the announcement. Tanner?
Yeah, Kate, this is the largest discretionary amount of money the county has ever received in their history. Over $506,000. $5,000. Using the money, they will resurface and fix McGee Chapel Road, Eubanks Road, and East Harmon's Ferry Road.
Officials tell me this program will help improve the infrastructure in the county. They say these roads service over 100 homes and other rural areas. Transportation Cabinet Deputy Secretary Paul Looney says the hope is fixing the roads will help McLean County's agriculture and mining industries.
When people leave their homes, they don't know if they're on a state road or a county road most times. They just know they're trying to get to work or school or church as efficiently and safely as they can. And so that's what we're really trying to help support.
I spoke with a homeowner on these roads. We'll hear their reaction coming up tonight on 14 News at 6.
A 14 News update on the collapse of a bourbon barrel storage warehouse in Davis County. OZ Tyler officials tell us they've been holding daily meetings with state and local officials, including representatives from the EPA. They say they've had minimal leakage from the barrels so far. Officials say they've been working with engineers and have decided, because of the extensive damage, it would be best to tear the rick house down. They'll move the unaffected barrels to another warehouse. Developing today, President Trump and the EPA announced a new policy for the nation's energy. The Affordable Clean Energy Rule is replacing Obama's Clean Power Plan. In support, Congressman Larry Bouchon says this new plan gives power back to the states and incentives for private investment in new, cleaner technologies. But others see this as a dirty power plan designed just to preserve the profits of the coal industry. Valley Watch President John Blair tells us he's not surprised Trump kept his promise to replace Obama's plan.
Over the last 30 years, we have made such significant progress in cleaning up our air quality and improving public health that it's, you know, to try to turn that clock back doesn't, I mean, it should make everybody in the tri-state angry because we are going to suffer.
An EPA analysis last year estimated Trump's replacement rule would kill an extra 300 to 1,500 people each year by 2030. That's due to additional air pollution from the power grid. New at 5, community health leaders came together to reveal the biggest health issues affecting our communities. Chelsea Brown was there and found this year's top four are different from the last time they did this sort of thing.
Well, Kate, the last time Vandenberg and Warwick counties did a community health needs assessment, the big issues included breast and prostate cancer, exercise and obesity. That was in 2016, but in 2019, mental health and substance abuse topped that list.
In a room filled with people who care about the future of our communities all in one place.
To help the community acknowledge, realize there is a problem.
Experts from local hospitals, social programs, mental health, and substance abuse specialists came together to pinpoint the health issues affecting the people of southwestern Indiana. Dr. William Wooten says the 2019 Community Health Needs Assessment shows substance abuse as a priority, both prevention and helping those addicted.
We want to promote effective prevention strategies and programs and help people access treatment and recovery options.
The assessment also pointed out mental health as another priority.
And you never know when a crisis or a concern may show up in someone's life or in the lives of someone that you know and love. So it's important for everybody to be aware of those signs and symptoms and also the resources where they can go to seek help.
And this survey shows access to care and food insecurity are also issues that need to be tackled.
What's exciting about it is we're looking at creative solutions. Sure, we do need more grocery stores that can help with that, but it's also looking at pop-up produce stands, other farmers markets, and access points for even our youth.
Step groups from the meeting today plan to start a public relations campaign to address mental health issues and concerns. We have the full assessment on our website and all of the solutions experts plan to use to tackle these problems on 14news.com and the 14 News app.
Thank you, Chelsea. In Webster County, senior citizens have a new place to hang out. Today was a ribbon cutting for the new senior center on North College Street in Dixon. It replaces the old center, which officials say was no longer efficient. The new space has meeting rooms, a dining area, and a place to socialize and watch TV. Now, next month, they plan to add exercise equipment. County leaders say none of this would be possible without the help of the community.
Webster County is a very caring community. Our rural heritage is just something that's bred within us that we're here to help one another. And so we have people that step up all the time, no matter what it is, to come in and help one another. And So it did not surprise me at all that when we talked about building a new senior building that we would have plenty of help.
Community leaders hope the new building will encourage more people to come to the center. More storms are moving into the area. Meteorologist Jeff Lyons is tracking the latest for us. And an investigation is underway after a ninth American tourist died recently in the Dominican Republic.
Dear coffee, you're fired. Your fancy foam and exotic blends are no match for my cockpit red leather seats and my zippy looks. I've got all the buzz now. Ciao, Camry.
Right now, you can get $1,000 customer cash on a new 2019 Toyota Camry. Find yours at buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Thunderstorms moving across the tri-state now. Our strongest ones over Hopkins County that will be moving into McLean and Muhlenberg County in the next half hour. We'll track the action and look ahead to our next round of thunderstorms in the First Alert forecast.
If you're looking for a luxury SUV that has it all, then look no further than DePatrick Audi on Green River Road. Packed with technology, safety, and wrapped in style, Audi has the perfect SUV for everyone. Like a new Audi Q5 for only $469 a month. Visit dpat.com today and explore all the Audi models available, including the all-new Audi Q8. Or see their beauty up close at DePatrick Audi on Green River Road. What's in your driveway?
Neighborhood Network is sponsored by J.E. Shekel.
When it's time to service your air conditioning and heating, turn to the experts at J.E. Shekel and Carrier. We're the people who know.
At Baptist Health, we want you to know the facts. Visit BaptistHealthTalks.com to view a video of pharmacist Margot Ashby on the Meds to Beds program. Baptist Health, Madisonville. Be a healthier you.
Closed captioning is sponsored by A-Pluster. Systems starting at $98 a month. On air and streaming with our news app. Streaming news is sponsored by Kenny Kent Toyota. Stop in and test drive the new RAV4. You're watching the Tri-State's news and weather leader. This is 14 News at 5.
An Ohio County man is in jail on sexual abuse charges. Sheriff's deputies say they arrested 36-year-old Aaron Crow of Hartford after an investigation into allegations of sexual abuse involving a minor. He's facing several charges, including sodomy sexual abuse. Crow made his first court appearance today. We have new information on a child pornography arrest we told you about on Friday at 5. 46-year-old William Ray Martin is facing new charges. Sheriff's deputies say this is his third arrest in just 4 days on charges related to child pornography. He was arrested in Vandenberg and in Warrick County for possession of child pornography. Deputies say as they were going through the thousands of images, they found videos of two juveniles who were recorded without their knowledge. Deputies say those videos were not pornographic. Now, Martin made his first court appearance today and is out of jail on bond. Another American tourist has died in the Dominican Republic, bringing the total to at least 9 deaths since last June. Kristen Holmes has the latest on the investigation.
We have no reason to believe that this death was of natural causes.
The family of 55-year-old Joseph Allen speaking out after he was found dead in a hotel room in the Dominican Republic last week.
Now, I know that my brother had a fever. He complained about being really hot. His friend looked at him. He was sweating bullets. Took a shower, cooled off, said he felt a lot better. He was going to hang out that night, decided, you know what, I feel better, but I don't feel well enough to hang, you know, to go hang out.
The New Jersey resident is the ninth American to die at a Dominican resort in the past year.
He had just gotten a physical prior to his trip. He had a clean bill of health.
Last month, an American couple from Maryland was found dead in their hotel room. According to the Dominican Republic, an autopsy concluded the couple had died of respiratory failure and pulmonary edema, a condition caused by excess fluid in the lungs. Now the FBI is working with Dominican authorities, assisting in further toxicology analysis. Officials in the Dominican Republic or the U.S. have not indicated that the deaths are connected. About 2.2 million American tourists visited the Dominican Republic last year, and officials in the country insist it is still safe to vacation there. I'm Kristen Holmes reporting.
People are literally on edge in Ohio, where a giant sinkhole is threatening homes. It's a nightmare that literally woke up one couple living inside a very unlucky building number 13. Their patio is losing the ground beneath it day by day, and wood slats are the only thing holding it up. Now, neighbors say the sinkhole has been creeping closer to their condos for the past few months. Things got worse Sunday when heavy rain made the sinkhole bigger and forced homeowners to evacuate. They're working with insurance companies to find an affordable fix. More storms are moving into the tri-state. Jeff is tracking the latest for us. And they were hoping for a different end to their baseball season, but the championship game result was the same as last year's for Southridge Raiders.
Meet your favorite Evansville news team. Get a picture with the 14 First Alert Interceptor and enjoy a baseball game at historic Bossy Field. It's 14 News Night at the Evansville Otters game, Thursday, June 27th at 6:30, when the Evansville Otters take on the Schaumburg Boomers. Join us for live coverage during our 6 p.m. newscast. Plus, we're giving away a Roku to one lucky fan every inning. Get your tickets now for 14 News Night with the Evansville Otters. 14 News, the Tri-State's news and weather leader.
Get 0% financing for 72 months or $9,000 in total savings on the 2019 Ford F-150 XLT.
In a wreck? I'm attorney Darrell Isaacs. If you've got questions, we've got answers.
Like, why shouldn't I file a claim on my own?
When you file a claim, you're taking on the big insurance company and their big team of attorneys. Here at Isaacs & Isaacs, we know the laws, we do the legwork, and we handle the paperwork.
What about all of my medical bills?
When we take your case, we'll work hard to get you the money you deserve for your medical bills and pain and suffering.
Call the hammer today.
One call, that's all.
1 Hour Heating and Air Conditioning knows how uncomfortable it gets when your AC goes out. You want it fixed fast, fixed right, and get a fast quote. Unlike some companies, we don't give you a quote until we actually see what the problem is.
Hey!
Then we'll give you a straightforward price and stand behind it. I meant buy it. We'll stand by it. Count on 1 Hour for an on-time guarantee.
Your comfort is just a call away. Call 1 Hour.
Our biggest savings event is back. The Just Buy It sale at DePatrick Nissan Used Cars on the Division Street Auto Plaza. So find it, drive it, love it, just buy it. Get huge tent sale savings on all vehicles. We have all makes and models, all at one location, so why shop anywhere else? Save big during the Just Buy It sale. Get your next used vehicle where service matters. DePatrick Nissan Used Cars on the Division Street Auto Plaza. What's in your driveway?
The leader in tracking storms. Here's your 14 First Alert forecast.
Showers and thunderstorms continue to move across the tri-state now. The greatest threat for severe weather is over western Kentucky. We do have a wet commute underway, though, in the metro area from Evansville to Henderson and soon Owensboro, Newburgh, and Rockport here, all getting in on rain, as well as Princeton and out toward Mount Vernon. A little closer look here, we do have some lightning strikes occurring over southern Henderson County at this time. And then farther down the line here, the strongest band of thunderstorms has cleared Madisonville and will be moving into southern McLean County here around Sacramento, and then western Muhlenberg County here in just the next few minutes. A little farther down, you see we do have severe thunderstorm warnings now just right up to Muhlenberg County. Doesn't include that just yet. I wanted to show you the wind data here because we've had some gust of 35 to 45 miles an hour, which is considerable. It certainly limits visibility, and it also may bring down some power lines and trees. Right now, the strongest wind gusts are out to the east of Madisonville here. Again, we're looking off the surface here a bit from where the radar is, which is in Paducah, and those winds showing up now probably at about 40 to 45 on the ground here in eastern Hopkins County, and then right here up to the Muhlenberg County line, perhaps a little stronger than that yet. So it wouldn't surprise me to see a severe thunderstorm warning on Muhlenberg County, but I'm not saying there's one there just yet. We're going to wait and see how these storms behave as they move through. We did not have one on Hopkins County, nor should we have. We just had heavy rain and gusty winds. So there's a third band of thunderstorms behind the one that's coming through Kentucky now, and this one will go over the same area. So we'll likely be looking at a heavy rain flooding threat as these storms train over the same areas. That severe thunderstorm watch has been whittled back even more now. It really just includes western Kentucky for us in the 14 news viewing area. So Union, Webster, Hopkins, and then McLean and Muhlenberg counties will stay in the watch at least another couple of hours. Rain dotting the lens there on our camera in downtown Evansville. A soggy day there for Shriners Fest setup. Hopefully we'll get the rain out of here for most of that event. 74, our current temperature now, and for tomorrow, expect more of the same. Some showers early and then sunny and humid during the afternoon as temperatures rise to around 80 degrees. The next round of rain will likely come in here on Friday. The latest data now on our models showing a line of thunderstorms developing on Friday morning and early afternoon and dropping in here during the midday or mid-afternoon hours. So that will be one to watch for Friday. At this time, we don't have an alert day on Friday. We'll look at some more data before we make that call. Over the weekend, up to 90 on Sunday, so hot and humid, and that will spawn additional showers and storms.
The Southridge Raiders baseball team played for the IHSAA Class 2A State Championship last night and unfortunately suffered one of the most heartbreaking losses you'll ever see. Aaron Hancock was there and has a recap.
Yeah, Kate, it was definitely one of the most gut-wrenching losses you will ever see. The Raiders were one strike away from winning the state championship 3-2 when it all went south. What's more, the Ridge got that third strike, but catcher Chase Taylor dropped the ball. His throw to first base then went sailing into the outfield, allowing the runner to take second. After that, a single to center then drove in the tying run to make it 3-3. And that hitter took second on an overthrow to home plate. And then Alexandria won it when a high pop fly fell in between two Raiders, allowing the game-winning run to score. The Tigers won 4-3, just a gut-wrenching way for Southridge to lose.
Nobody feels worse than Chase. You know, it's not on him, it's not on Colson, it's not on Patrick. You know, all the guys that are hanging their heads, it's gonna hurt like crazy. And I'm glad to a little bit that it does because it means they care. But it's a game. I told them afterwards, it's a game. You know, it's not gonna change how I feel about them. Whether they make a play on a diamond, their value isn't created in what they do on the field. It's who they are as people. And I love all of them.
One bright spot was senior Joe LaGrange was named the L.V. Phillips Mental Attitude Award winner. We'll have more on that and the game coming up at 10. Kate?
A big award today for a Princeton mail carrier. She saved a man on her route for the second time.
It's a different kind of work week out here. You need the power, performance, and enough attachments to scratch any itch. A subcompact tractor built to get any job done right. The Kubota BX Series, best-selling subcompact tractor in America. Now get a BX 1880 for payments as low as $99 a month for 84 months plus a 6-year warranty. 54-inch mower deck included.
Find a Kubota dealer near you at GoKubota.com.
It's the Ram Bigger Things sales event at Expressway Dodge. Bigger, huge, more ginormous than ever. Now, $18,000 off on this 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab Limited 4x4. Our biggest savings ever. New 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab Bighorn 4x4, $377 a month. Zero down, sign and drive. Go bigger at Expressway Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Evansville. $18,000 off.
Give your home's interior or exterior an update with a new Mastercraft door from Menards and save with 11% off everything. Mastercraft is the name to know for top quality doors. Menards carries beautiful doors to fit the style that's right for you. Choose from our huge selection of stock doors or design your door your way with our door designer in store or on Menards.com. Save big money with 11% off all Mastercraft doors at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Cool down in a hot new ride from E-Patch 4.
Get a newer, nicer, safer vehicle and lower your monthly payment.
That's right. Trade in and trade up.
Nearly 1,000 new Fords in stock.
Over 700 low-mileage pre-owned vehicles from all major brands. Plus more on the way.
And you'll save cold, hard cash.
Visit the lot or go to DeepPatrickFord.com.
We have the Tri-State's largest selection of new Ford F-150s.
More than double any other local dealer.
DePatrick Ford, the largest volume new Ford and Lincoln dealer in the Tri-State. Highway 41 in the Lloyd and DePatrickFord.com.
No matter what your plans are, 99.5 WKDQ is right there with you. Pull us up on your phone with the WKDQ app and stream your favorite country music while you enjoy time with family and friends. Let us help the workday go quicker with 9 in a row every hour on your Alexa-powered device as you're working 99 to 5. When you're relaxing or when you're on the go. You're number one for new country, no matter what you're doing. 99.5 WKDQ.
A Tri-State mail carrier was honored today for being a hero to a man on her route, not once, but twice. Post office officials gave Michaela Akers the Postmaster General Hero Award today in Princeton. Akers says she heard the man calling for help from his kitchen. He'd fallen and needed medical help. She stayed with him until EMTs arrived. Akers helped the same man a second time when she found him unable to get up from where he'd fallen in his yard. And while Akers says she's honored to receive the award, helping others is just a part of the job.
We do see different things every day. That's the kind of cool thing about my job. It's whether it's bad weather or people, or and then you get to be a quote-unquote hero for helping someone when anyone would do it.
This is the second Princeton mail carrier to receive the award in the last 2 months. Mark Hsu earned the award in April for helping a customer during a dog attack.
And we have thunderstorms. Kate, as you saw there on the radar, let's check them out again here. The heaviest stuff now moving into Muhlenberg County and southern McLean County. No warnings down there, but 40-mile-an-hour winds and maybe some small hail, very heavy rain and lightning are certainly on the way over the next hour and then on into Hartford, Kentucky there in Ohio County. For the metro area, it's just rain right now with some thunder.
Great. We can hear that here in the station.
Yes, we
as well.
Can.
Thanks for joining us on 14 News at 5. Join us again for more news at 6. Have a great night.
Stay prepared when breaking news or severe weather happens by downloading the 14 News apps. This message is sponsored by Dean Bosler's Furniture, home of Bassett's HGTV Home Design Gallery.